Say hi, Meadow. Do you want to see what my new kick is? It's really weird what my new kick is. These guys are probably going to laugh at me. Should I show you? I've been collecting not just bandanas.
Fuzzy socks.
Cozy socks. I love Canada, and I like to wear cozy socks and go hiking and look at mountains and gaze at the stars. Who else likes that? Who else wants to collect these cute little fuzzy cozy socks? And you wear, I wear leggings, I wear my tights, okay, and then I put cozy socks on and I wear cool sneakers with it. Who else likes to dress like that? Because it's really awesome. Cozy socks and bandanas. That's what kind of girl I am. And Cadillacs.
They're so, okay? They're so soft inside.
Winners. I like winners. Winners. Thank you, winners. I asked the guy in there. Sweet, 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 sweet guy in there. He was working at the register. Okay. God bless you. Shout out to Rohit. I said, how's your night? Because he hold up the jacket. Meadow, I seen a beautiful jacket. It's white like mine. And it's Nautica. And it has black fur on the hood. You want it?
Oh, wow. I didn't.
Huh?
I didn't see what it looks.
It's medium. It will fit you. I took a picture. And I'm going to show it. So
okay.
I was trying to take a picture of it. I was trying to take a picture of this beautiful jacket for Meadow. And she doesn't want to wear my jacket. And I literally kept trying to buy her a jacket. She didn't choose one.
Well,
so I said, wear mine for now.
There was cute ones, but they didn't fit me.
They didn't
the ones
fit her.
That I liked.
They didn't fit her because she's voluptuous for a young girl. So, long story short, now she's all shy. I asked him, he was holding it up for me, the jacket. I was trying to take a picture and he's like, I'll hold it up. I was like, oh my goodness, you're so sweet. So, when I started talking, I was like, how's your night? He's like, what do you mean, day, night, day? My day wasn't so good. And I knew what he was about to say. I'm like, we're stuck here, huh? People don't want to work 9-to-5s. People are stuck at their 9-to-5s, not living the life they want to live. I said, you want me to help you earn online? He's like, absolutely. I said, I paid off $30,000 worth of debt. I bought a new Escalade. I literally separated with my husband, and this has made me an incredible fortune. And I have a mother of five. He's like, you're a mother of five? I say, yes, I'm a mother. I built a gym in my house. I literally restored my backyard. Did so much. And he gave me props. He's like, good for you. I was like, thank you, brother. And to say that and to be able to help people do the same is incredible. I'm extremely hot. I don't know if you can tell. Ooh, it's hot in here. These kids have the heat up real high. So,
hi,
hi, babies. My Canadian kids in the back there. Woo, Canada. I love. You know I'm American. I love Canada. Oh, see, someone just messaged me and wants more info for my business. Now, that's the thing. I'm so grateful that I can help other people earn online, earn an incredible income online, because I know I'm going to help this young man and I'm going to help him rock the online world and make an incredible income and not have to go to a 9-to-5, not have to, you know, break his back for someone else and build their empire and not build his empire, because that's what's happening. People are building other people's empire. They don't want to be stuck at their 9-to-5s. They don't want to be overworked and underpaid. Everywhere in Kamloops right now is understaffed because a lot of people are mandated to take a shot and they don't want to. And there's also a lot of people are leaving their JOBs just because they woke up and they're like, I don't want to do this anymore. I want to do what I want to do. COVID made me like realize, okay, I want to change. So we actually went to the dollar store first because that's where these kids want to go. Well, I asked them, where did you want to go shopping? They said, I asked them, it's the twins' birthday. Happy birthday, twinsies. When I asked you what place that you want to go shopping, I'll take you anywhere. Where'd you guys say?
Dollar store.
The dollar store. So I have to take them. If you see the previous video, they picked out whatever they wanted, because usually I'm like, no, no, that's not good quality. No, we're not going to get that. No, I can buy you better stuff at the mall or at Winners. I'll get you a Nike hat. I'll get you Adidas stuff. I'll do this. I'll do that. I'm all about quality. I want my kids to have quality stuff. And like, toys will break and whatever, but I let them pick everything out. We spent $101 at the dollar store, at Dollarama. Really? They managed to, yeah.
Wow.
But they got some cool hats. Those are my favorite. Those hats were worth about 50 bucks alone. Honestly. And we got some good snacks. Then I stopped and got some cozy socks at Winners. We're gonna go, Gio. Cozy socks and high tops. Cozy socks and high tops. Alright guys, peace out. I'm going to take these kids home. And they're going to have their cake. They had a late night. I let them have a late night. They want to play all day and they still want to go shopping. And they had a blast. They had a blast. So, you know what, guys? A lot of people are freaking out and saying, you know, they just want to go out. And they want to go to a restaurant. They want to go here. And COVID stopped them. Guess what? During these times, I took time for myself and my children to just be peaceful. We explored nature. We went hiking. We went to falls. We went, had bonfires. We cooked and ate the best. We restored our house. We just went on beautiful adventures, guys. Just really, really, really start to seek spirituality. Start to seek, you know, one with yourself. Become one with yourself. Don't think you need to go to an outing to make you happy. Like, you know, you need to be in an extravagant place or wherever. Sometimes you just need that peace, right? Sometimes you just need that, you know, even fresh air for a walk. You know, it's free to go for a hike. It's free, you know, you'll pay gas or whatever, to go for a drive, listen to some music with your kids. Like, I literally do that sometimes. Like, I say, let's go. You just want to go? We'll go for here or there, and I literally will, you know, take them to get, like, fast food, or, like, I'll get them Taco Bell. We'll go for a drive. We'll sit at the Riverside Park, and we're sitting in the car, and we're looking at the mountain and the beautiful water, and, you know, or we go for a walk there. Like, that's at night or something. Like, there's so many simple things that's free in life. Okay, your freedom is free. Get it. Get that freedom. You have that freedom. What's keeping you from having your freedom is your fear from making a change. Guys, whoever is waiting and on the fence of starting this business, hop out of your comfort zone and get on board, because you're missing out on freedom. Okay, this business gave me full freedom to do whatever I want, buy whatever I want, go wherever I want, do whatever I want, eat whatever I want, drink whatever I want. Like, it was, you know what? I'm vegan. I'm a health freak. And when I had to worry about how, like, I had to worry about how, like, to buy the stuff that I wanted to buy. Because what does the world do to us? All right, walk into McDonald's, salad's 10 bucks, a hamburger's $2. That don't make any sense when it's a lot more money to even, you know, make an animal, you know, grow and feed them and whatever. Long story short, the system, the world, does not want us to stay healthy. Does not want us to be powerful. Does not want us to be rich. Beat the system. Get out of the system. Eat healthy. Work out. Wake up early. Kill the empire. We're leaving soon, Gio. Yes, we're going. Sorry. Sorry, little guy. Where do you want to go? You want to go home? All right, they want to get out. So, I just wanted to tell you guys that. Like, the system wants to keep you where? Below. Hi, Steph. Love you, girl. Hi, Sunday. Don't let the system beat you. Beat the system. FEAR. The acronym for FEAR. FEAR stands for False Events Appearing Real. Don't let your fears get the best of you. Jump out of your comfort zone. Become an online entrepreneur. And I want to congratulate Devin. Devin won first place. He jumped out of his comfort zone, went live. I had a challenge to go live, you know, just to empower yourself. Talk a little bit about yourself. And he won first place, and he was so casual about it. And I said that just casual live, you know, in our group chat, in our group here on Facebook. So God bless my team, Team Integrity, because we are full of integrity. And then Angela went live with Erica, her mentees. She helps them in this business. She helped train them and everything so they can do incredible. And they are doing incredible, Paul and Erica. They won second place, and she's making the new challenge. Third place, my business partner, Chantel. for being most interesting on video. Angela and her business partners were most entertaining. They was in a hot tub and it was like, wow. They're in a pool out in Lake County. I was like, wow, that's awesome. Or was it Lake Country? Anyways, fourth place was Ruth. Oh my goodness. Ruth, you're incredible. She won $200. Devin won $100. Even though that she wasn't first place, she was fourth. She literally, she won fourth place. I made an extra award. There's only three awards because she persevered in that video. She was nervous. She couldn't breathe. She was like, I can't do this. Oh my goodness. I'm used to going live with Georgia. And she did it. And she talked about her life and why she started this business. And I was like, oh my goodness. Not only am I going to give her double the amount, I have to make another award for her. So I made another award. I gave her double the amount. You know, was it wrong, right, for her to not do good as video? She was so nervous. No, it took guts. I think of the parable of the talents. You know, when they all, like, the parable of the talents and also the parable of the workers in the vineyard. When the last, they brought one at like 9 a.m. They brought another person at 3 p.m. And the ones at 9 a.m. was working the scorching heat all day. And the one that came at like 3 p.m. or whatever, they got the same pay. They all got the same pay. And then the workers got mad that was there till like 9, from like 8 or 9 a.m. all day. They said, why did you pay him the same amount we all got? Why don't you pay us more? And the vineyard owner said, is it wrong? Is it wrong for me to pay them the same wage? No. It's not wrong. He said, I'm going to do what I want to do with my money. In the same way, that's what God... I always think about that. I love that parable. God will bless the Christian that just came in from sinning, doing wrong. He'll bless him the same way as that sinner, as that Christian that's been in church your whole life. That's also the parable of the lost sheep. But anyways, I just felt that way about Ruth. I was like, okay, this girl totally had so much anxiety on there. She didn't have to do the challenge. She did it though. And she wasn't as casual or laid back or genuine like Devin. Devin got first place because he totally rocked it. But I was like, this girl, she did poorly. And she persevered. She persevered. And that's what happens in life. Sometimes we make poor mistakes. Sometimes we sin. Sometimes we do wrong. Sometimes you go through a certain situation. You wish you never made that mistake. You wish you never made that decision. You wish you never was with a certain person. Whatever the case may be, you can always, always, always recover. You can always do better tomorrow. You can always ask for forgiveness. God loves you. And he's put you here for a very, very special reason. And I love you too. Okay, I gotta go. My kids are gonna kill me. All right, bye guys.
Bye.
Bye. Peace out, guys. I'll see you later.